Hello everybody, today we are going to see some theorems, okay, from the lesson quadrilateral. Already we have seen one theorem of angles, some property of quadrilateral. Now we are going to see next theorem, that is a diagonal of parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Okay, once again see, a diagonal of parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Okay, here parallelogram is given, ABCD is a parallelogram. We all are knowing that properties of parallelogram. Okay, opposite sides are equal and parallel. Means here we can say AD and BC are parallel to each other, as well as AB and CD are parallel to each other. Okay, also opposite angles are equal. Okay, these are the main properties of parallelogram which we have seen. Okay, so now depend on this, we are going to give here proof for this statement. Okay, so for first, you will take here given. What is given? A diagonal of parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Means here a diagonal parallelogram is given. ABCD is a quadrilateral. ABCD is a parallelogram. Is a parallelogram. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. AC is the diagonal. AC is the diagonal. AC is the diagonal. A diagonal of parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Means here we have to prove triangle ABC and triangle ADC are congruent. Okay, so that we are going to prove here. That is our target. Triangle ABC. Congruent triangle ABC. Okay, angle ABC and ADC are congruent. Okay, that we have to prove. So now here in proof, this proof is very simple. We can write. See, first we will think about how we can give, how we can prove both the triangles are congruent. So for that, we know AD and BC, opposite side of a parallelogram, and that are parallel, as well as AB and DC are parallel. If we will think about AC, okay, if we are going to think about AD and BC are parallel, that then AC will work as a transversal. AC will work as a transversal, means this is working as a transversal. So alternate interior angle, this angle and this angle will be same. Okay, as well as we can say this angle and this angle, the same reason, alternate interior angle. When two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, that time alternate interior angles are equal. According to this, we can say DAC is equal to BCA. Okay, first thing we got. Second thing, with the help of same reason, we can write here this and this is correct. Same, these two angles are same. Then we can write DCA and BAC are equal, alternate interior angles. Because AC is working as a transversal. And third thing we can write, AC is the common side for both the triangles. So by angle side angle, by ASA, we can say both the triangles are congruent. Understood? If triangles are congruent, the it divides into two equal triangles. Okay, so here in proof we will think about in triangle ABC and triangle ABC, then CDA. AD is parallel to BC and AB is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC and AB is parallel to BC. Okay, so here we can say AC is a transversal. AC is a transversal. Okay, AC is a transversal, so we can write DAC angle, DAC is equal to BCA angle, is equal to angle BCA. What is the reason? Alternate interior angles, alternate interior angles. Okay, so these two angles are equal. So here I am saying this and this angle is equal. Okay, now we can say AC is equal to AC. AC is equal to AC. Common side for both the triangles. Common side for both the triangles. For this and this. Okay, so angle side over. Now third thing we can say BAC, BAC congruent equal to DCA. Angle BAC is equal to angle DCA. Okay, with the help of same reason, alternate interior angles. Okay, so now here two angles and included side. So we can say by ASA angle side angle both the triangles are congruent. So finally we can say this. I am saying here this is first, this is second, and this is third. Okay, so triangle ABC congruent triangle CDA by angle side angle by ASA criteria both the triangles are congruent. And what they are asking, a diagonal of parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Okay, two congruent triangles. Okay, these two triangles we got due to the diagonal AC. So this diagonal divides this quadrilateral into two congruent triangles. Okay, so this was very simple proof. See carefully and then solve your problem. Okay, see here our second theorem is, in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. In a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. Okay, just now we have seen theorem number 1. Okay, the same explanation here we need to give. Okay, so see here, in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. Parallelogram is given. So in first thing we will mention here, given quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. We have to prove AB is equal to DC and AD is equal to BC. Opposite sides are equal, that we need to show. Okay, so directly we cannot show. This is one of the property of parallelogram, but that property now we are going to prove. Understood? So here we will join AC or DE, any one diagonal you can take here. That is, I am joining here AC. Okay, so here in construction we mention construction join AC. Okay, now due to this diagonal the parallelogram is divided into two triangles. Now if we are able to prove both the triangles are congruent, then automatically we can say by simplicity we can say, see, if this and this triangle both the triangles are congruent, then we can say AB is equal to DC and AD is equal to BC. By simplicity, triangles are congruent. So first we are going to prove here triangles are congruent. Okay, and what is theorem? In a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. Okay, so in proof we will think about both the triangles. Just like we have seen, the same explanation will come here. Okay, so here AC is CD is parallel to AB. Okay, and CD is parallel to AB and AD is parallel to BC and AD is parallel to BC. CD is parallel to AB and AD is parallel to BC. Okay, so now here if sides are parallel, then AC will work as a transversal. So we can see here angle, if this is transversal and these two are parallel, so AD and BC is parallel. So here we can see this and this is equal. Okay, and this angle is equal by alternate interior angle. So here we can mention DCA angle, D BCA is equal to angle BAC, angle BAC, alternate interior angles, alternate interior angles. Okay, alternate interior angles are equal. Same reason here we can give. Just now we told DCA, DCA. Now here we can say DAC is equal to angle DAC is equal to DAC is equal to BCA, angle BCA. That is also the same reason, alternate interior angles. Okay, now two angles we have. AC is the common side for both the triangles. So now we will say triangle, or directly also we can mention here triangles, and we can give three things. For first we can give this proof, and then we can take both the triangles and we can compare. So this I am saying, this is first one, this is second one. So now we will think about two triangles. In triangle ACD, in triangle ACD and triangle CAB, CAB. Okay, what we can do here? This we can give angle BCA is equal to angle BAC from 1. That is angle. Then we can say AC is equal to AC. That is common side for both the triangles. Common side. And third one, this thing. That is angle DAC is equal to angle BCA from second. So we have two angles and one side, two angles and one included side. So we can say by ASA, by angle side angle, both the triangles are congruent. So here we can take triangle ACD, triangle ACD congruent triangle CAB, CAB by angle side angle, by ASA criteria both the triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then we can say, according to the statement, we can say AB is equal to CD, AB is equal to CD, and AD is equal to BC. Okay, that is by CPCD, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay, so by CPCD we can say this, and that was our target. Okay. Okay, see here our theorem number 3 is the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, so here parallelogram is given. So in given things, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram, that is given. Now we have to prove opposite angles. To prove opposite angle, then angle A is equal to angle C and angle D is equal to angle D, that we have to prove. Okay, so now proof, we will think about proof. Okay, so before that we will have a little discussion about this figure. Okay, this is parallelogram. So definitely CD and AB are parallel to each other. Also AD and DC are parallel to each other. Okay, so when CD and AB are parallel to each other, okay, that time AD is working as a transversal. AD is working as a transversal. Okay, these two lines are parallel and this is a transversal. That time these two angles, sum of these two angles will be 180 degree, because angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. Okay, so that we will bring on the paper first. So first we will take here DC is parallel to AB and AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. DC is parallel to AB and AD is parallel to BC. Okay, when DC is parallel to AB, DC is parallel to AB, that time AD is a transversal. AD is a transversal. AD is a transversal. This is transversal. So we can say angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. Okay, that we will say first one. 180 degree. Why? interior angles on the same side of transversal. Interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplemented. Okay, sum of these two angles is 180. Okay, now this, when AD is parallel to BC, okay, when AD is parallel to BC, AD is parallel to BC, that time DC is working as a transversal. Okay, so DC is a transversal. DC is a transversal. So we can say angle D plus angle C is equal to 180. Angle D plus angle C is equal to 180. Okay, the same reason, interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplemented. Interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplemented. Okay, so D plus C is equal to 180 degree, A plus D is equal to 180. Okay, the sum of these two is 180, sum of these two is 180. So we can compare this two. Okay, because RHS is same. So angle A plus angle D is equal to angle D plus angle C. So here we can give from 1 and 2. Okay, angle A plus D is equal to D plus C, because value is same. Sum of this is 180 and sum of these two angles is also 180. So here angle D plus angle C. So here angle D we can cancel. So what is remaining here? Angle A is equal to angle C. Angle A and angle C are equal. Okay. So similarly we can show. Here we can write only similarly. Similarly angle D is equal to angle B. Not necessary to show again this. We can show, we can write here similarly. This way we can give proof for this also. Angle D is equal to angle B, and that was our target. The opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay. Okay, see here, theorem number 4 is the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, parallelogram is given. So first we will mention here, given quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. The diagonals AC and DB, AC and DB are the diagonals. Diagonals bisect are the intersecting at point O. Both the diagonals are intersecting here, and that point is O. Okay, and what we have to write, the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Bisect each other means we have to prove here, we have to prove AO is equal to CO, AO is equal to CO, and BO is equal to B. This we have to prove. Okay, so in proof, what we will do first, the same reason, DC and AD are parallel, also AD and BC are parallel to each other. Okay, because this is a parallelogram. So now we can write here, DC is parallel to AD and BC is parallel to AD and AD is parallel to BC. Okay, because quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram, that is given. So with the help of this we can write this. Okay, so now when DC is parallel to AB, BC is parallel to AB, BC is parallel to AB, that time AC is a transversal. First we will think about AC, that is diagonal of this quadrilateral or parallelogram. So we can write here AC is transversal. AC is transversal. Okay, if these two lines are parallel and AC, we are thinking about AC, then we can write this angle and this angle is equal by alternate interior angles. alternate interior angles. Understood? So that I am taking first here, that is DCA angle DCA is equal to DCA is equal to BAC angle BAC. Okay, so DCA is equal to BAC. Why? Alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles because lines are parallel but by transverse. Okay, so DCA angle DCA we can write angle DCO also because here angle is important. We can write DCA equals to DCO. So here I am taking angle DCO is equal to BAO angle BAO. DCO is equal to BAO. Okay, so because this and this angle is same, so here I am saying this is first. Okay, so now this angle we have. Now we will think about this, this and this angle. Okay, so now can we say this and this angle is equal? Okay, when both the angles are equal, DB is a transversal. DB is a transversal. DC is parallel to AB. DC is parallel to AB. DC is parallel to AB. Okay, and DB is a transversal. And DB is a transversal. Transversal. DB is a transversal. That time we can say CDP angle. CDP is equal to ABD angle ABD. Okay, CDB is equal to ABD. This is again the same reason, alternate interior angles are equal. Okay, so now CDB I can write CDO angle CDO is equal to ABD. ABD we can write ABO angle ABO. Okay, this is we will say second. Okay, now we will think about both the triangles. Now we are going to think about this and this triangle. Okay, so in triangle DOC DOC and triangle DOC BOA. What we can do here? First thing we have this angle and this angle is equal according to the first. So that I am taking here angle DCO is equal to angle BAO from 1. Okay, this angle is equal to this. Then DC is equal to AB. DC is equal to AB because opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. And now third thing we can take here, that is angle CDO is equal to angle ABO. Okay, from second. Okay, this reason we have given here why these two angles are equal. Okay, so CDO is equal to ABO. So now angle side angle ASA, two angles and included side are equal to the two angles and included side of another triangle. That time both the triangles are congruent by ASA condition. Okay, so from that we can write here triangle DOC congruent triangle BOA by angle side by ASA triangle. Okay, now what we have to do, if both the triangles are congruent, then we can write OD is equal to OB and OA is equal to OC. Why? What reason we can write? CP, CD, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay? So this is very simple theorem, and theorems are important for this year and for next year also. So learn it properly, and today you have to do the practice of these four theorems only. Okay? Thank you very much.